sunny shots of the
ladies and gentlemen, while we have a few moments here, I would like to read out the complete rosters for both football teams that will be playing this homecoming game today. And I will begin with the visiting team, the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers. Number one is Jovan Choker. Number two is Nate Swing. Three is Jack Roberts. Four is Eli Melnick. Five is Eddie Amirose. Six, Logan Wager. Seven, Tyson Gale. Eight is Javen Knapp. Nine is William Petroya. 10, Jackson Allen. 11, Alozi LaRose. 12, Adam Lawton. 17 is Luca Liberatore. 18 is Gibran Vargas. 21, Josh Van Conant. 22, Peyton Mansfield. 23, Keaton McPherson. 27, Jacob Lepi. 33 is Sukhjot Singh. 35, Simon Weitner. 36 is Wilson Box. 44, Chase Thurston. 50 is Tyrell Bajwa. 55, Peyton Ogden. 56 is Gabriel Perez. 60, Rory Gibson. 64, Jaden Forbes. 65, Navin Flynn. 70 is Declan Ferguson. 73, Quentin Bryant. 78, Mateo Kopech. 80 is Tyler Jones. And 85 is Logan Ginther. There you have your starting lineup for the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers. And now for your 2022 St. Thomas More Collegiate Knights, here is your roster. Number one, Joseph Sapatula. Two, Dennis Lavis. Three, Matthew Hall. Four, Jack Sutherland. Five is Gavin Shaw. Six, Noah Perea. Seven, Dunedin Lee Daniel. Eight is Marcus Morales. Nine, Brandon Johal. 10, A.J. Castillo. 11 is Aaron Haber. 12, Sal Piccolo. 16 is Virgin Sidhu. 17 is Michael Camucci. 19, Matthew Custodio. 20 is Nico Perales. 21 is Malachi Hayford. 24, Tristan Kabidi. 28, Chase Sigenfredo. 30, Owen Christensen. 33 is Ryan Wang. 40, Bruno Napolitano. 44, Francesco Murdoco. 45, Leonardo Lua Rivera. 51 is Mateo De Castro. 52, Gray Harmer. 55, Callum Rogers. 56, Aiden Whiting Hewlett. 57, Nicholas B. Ulick. 58, Sebastian Gorey. 60 is Jarrell Benesaglin. 66, Alex Jasper. 70, Rashawn Canetti. 72, Lucas Crescenzo. 73, Milan Fernandez. 74 is Wyatt Cully. 75 is Dominic Cully. 76, Evander Sidhu. 77, Kevin Nicklin. 79, Everett Adams. 80 is Nico Kanagawa. And 88 is Marcus Malinowski. There you have your starting lineup for your St. Thomas More Collegiate Knights.
Thank you, Mr. Schaefer Carter. You are a rock star. Welcome everybody to Homecoming 2022. Let's make some noise! Alright, before we begin, this is kind of crazy, but right behind me, we have a wedding going on. And this wedding, I don't know if they can hear us or not, is for two 2012 STMC graduates, Leah Singer and Justin Siglos. Graduates of STM 2012 are tying the knot right behind us right now. So give them a big round of applause, Leah and Justin. Before we start our prayer, I'd like to state that St. Thomas More Collegiate recognizes that we are in the ancestral and unceded homelands of the Hunkamiam and Squamish-speaking peoples. We are very grateful and blessed to be on this territory. If we could just silence for a prayer, everybody, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. We pray for those families and communities so negatively affected by residential schools. We pray that truth and reconciliation happens in a real and tangible way, helping those who need it most. We thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to come together as a community at homecoming. We will always remember Coach Bernie Cully. He is here today in spirit. We can feel his presence, and we as Knights continue to strive to be humble, hardworking people and people of faith, just as Bernie modeled each and every day. Coach Cully, thank you for showing us these admirable qualities. We feel you today. We feel you every day. May our game together give us a greater appreciation for each other's gifts and talents. May our game be free of injury and leave us with good memories. Finally, students, if you could help me out, we will end with the Edmund Rice prayer. Oh God, we thank you for the life of blessed Edmund Rice. He opened his heart to Christ present and those oppressed by poverty and injustice. May we follow his example of faith and generosity. Grant us the courage, compassion of blessed Edmund as we seek to live lives of love and service. We ask this in Christ our Lord. Amen. St. Thomas More, blessed Edmund Rice, live Jesus in our hearts. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. All right, I'm so proud to introduce you to our national anthem singer, grade 12 student, Courtney Castres.
Center field, and we're going to get this show on the road. had the coin toss with the captains of both football teams, and it looks like Tweedsmuir will be receiving the kickoff. About 3 yards from up here. It'll be second and 13 here for Lord Tweedsmuir. Choker again handing the ball off to Jackson Allen, number 10. Number 24, Tristan Kabidi in on the tackle for the Knights. Jack Sutherland, number 4, also in the vicinity, lending a hand on that play. That 3-yard run brings the ball back to the original line of scrimmage, and it'll be 3rd and 10 from the 20. Again looking for number 10, Jackson Allen. That pass goes incomplete. I believe number 28 for the Knights, that's Chase Sivinfredo, was there on the defense for St. Thomas More. So the Panthers will be forced to kick the punt away. And back for the Knights, we have number 80, that is Nico Kanagawa. Yeah. pass punt by number 23, Keaton McPherson, was blocked. Number 11 in on the play, that is Aaron Javier. So with the ball going through the end zone, the Knights are on the board with 2 points for the safety. And again, they'll be receiving the kickoff there from the Panthers. Noah Faria, number 6, and Matthew Custodio, number 19, are waiting deep for the Knights. Tweedsmuir McPherson getting set to tee it up for Lord Tweedsmuir. Number 10, Jackson Allen, and number 4, Eli Mellick. Another good game by the Knights of about 8 yards. It'll bring up second and two. That is Shaw again on the carry. He'll be close to the first down. 73 in on the tackle there. That's Quentin Bryant. Shaw carrying the ball down to the Lord Tweedsmuir 20-yard line. Good for the first down. First and 10 Knights. Got not before a big game there. By number 33, Ryan Ray. Bringing the ball inside the 10-yard line for the Knights to approximately the Panther 9, and it'll be first and goal from there. There's a flag on the play prior to the snap of the ball. False start is the call against the Knights. That'll move the ball back 5 yards, and it'll be first and goal from the 14-yard line for St. Thomas More. Number 7, the intended receiver, that's Deneen Lee Daniel. Ball goes incomplete on the coverage there for the Panthers is number 6, Logan Wager. So it'll be second and goal for St. Thomas More from the 14.
I'm free. I'm just staying on one for now.
AJ Castillo taking the ball himself, and he was brought down to number 5. That is Amius.
Okay, hold on. Look like this way? Oh.
AJ Castillo with a gain of 4 on that play, bringing it to the 10. It'll be third and goal from there for the Knights. Number 20, that is Nico Perales taking the ball for St. Thomas More. I believe it was Logan Wager, number 6, in on the tackle for the Panthers. It'll be about 4th and 5 to go here for the Knights. Number 12, Sal Piccolo has come on the field for the field goal here. And he puts it through the uprights. Coach St. Thomas More has taken a 5-0 lead here on the Panthers in the first quarter. And while I have a moment, I would, during the game, I will be announcing some of the sponsors who have been very generous to the St. Thomas More Collegiate program. And I will begin with All Western Electric Limited. Thank you very much for your support. Class number 22, Keaton McPherson. And number 6, Logan Wager, back deep for the Panthers, awaiting the stick here by number 12, Sal Piccolo. There's a touchback there for the Panthers, and they'll begin first and 10 again at their 20. Golden shoulder handing the ball off. It was number 10 again, Jackson Allen on the carry, and he looks to be shaken up on the play. Making the tackle there for St. Thomas More was number 76, that's Evander Sandu. It's good to see Jackson Allen back up on his feet. So that last play did not go for any game. It'll be second and 10 here for the Tweedsmuir from their own 20. down by number 4, Jack Sutherland. Callum Rogers, 55, and number 24, Tristan Cabidi, also in the vicinity, helping out on that tackle. That was a, we'll call it a 2-yard gain there by Hermios. And it'll be 3rd and 8 here for the Panthers. A timeout has been called on the field by the Knights. Thank you. number 33, Ryan Lang. Again, taking the handoff from A.J. Castillo. And Eddie Edwards again, number 5 for the Panthers, making the tackle. And Wang was short of the first round right there, and it'll be fourth and yard. So that touchdown will be brought back. After the penalty, the ball has been marked down at the Panthers' 30-yard line. The Knights will begin first and 10 from there after that call. A.J. Castillo hitting number 33, Ryan Wang, with that pass. Jack Roberts, number 3, was in on the play for the Panthers. A gain of 6 by Ryan Wang. Second and 4 Knights. AJ Castillo handing the ball off to Gavin Shaw. Eddie Amios was in on the tackle for the Panthers. The ball has been placed at the Panthers 20. Good for the first down. And that was the final play of the first quarter with the score, the St. Thomas More Collegiate Knights 5. And the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers, no score. And the Prado Cafe has been sponsors for St. Thomas More. Number 6, Noah Faria, taking the handoff from A.J. Castillo. Number 36, Wilson Box, made the tackle for the Panthers. No gain on the play. A second and 10 Knights. Thank you. Castillo hitting number five, Gavin Schroff. Jack Roberts made the tackle. Game three, it'll be third and seven for the Knights. And St. Thomas More Collegiate would also like to say a big thank you to Paul and Maria Van Fleet as being the sponsor to our program. That is number five, Gavin Shaw, going up the middle for a big game for the Knights. Nate Swing, number two, and number four, Eli Melnick, were in on the tackle for the Panthers. But not before Gavin Shaw gets the yardage for the first down. It'll be first and goal from the five for the Knights. Gavin Shaw met right at the line of scrimmage. 21 was there. That is Josh Van Konit. He had help from number five, Eddie Amios. A loss of three on that play. That'll make it second and goal from the eight. from their 26. Lots of flags on the field here. And the offside's been called against the Knights, so that'll move it 5 yards. And it'll be 1st and 5 here for the Panthers. The ball is now at the 33-yard line. Number 10, Jackson Allen, back in the game, taking a handoff from Jordan Shelker. Brandon Johal, number 9, and number 3, Matthew Owl, in on the tackle for the Knights. Jackson Allen taking it out to their 40-yard line, good for the first down, 1st and 10 Panthers. There is a flag in the backfield, however. Matthew Wall, number 3, made the tackle for the Knights. We'll see what the flag's about. A personal foul has been called against the Knights. And this will move it 15 yards. This will take the ball down to the 35-yard line at St. Thomas North. And the little Tweedsmuir Panthers will have a 1st and 10 from there. Number 10, Jackson Allen taking the handoff from Choker, and he was not close with the line of scrimmage. Number 77, Kevin Nicklin making the tackle for the Knights. Looks like there was a loss of a yard on that play, and that'll bring up a 2nd down and 11 to go here for the Panthers. Choker looking downfield for Nate Swing, number 2, pass goes incomplete. Number 12 on the coverage there, Sal Piccolo. That incompletion will bring up a 3rd down, 3rd and 11 here for the Panthers. The ball is at the 36-yard line of St. Thomas More. And the Panther has been shaken up on the play. I believe that's number 55, Caden Ogden. Thank you. Nice to see number 55 taking off and back on the speed. Let's hope he'll be all right. So the Panthers are looking at the 3rd and 11 here. We're at the mid 36. Jackson Allen again throwing the ball, taking the handoff from Jordan Schulter. Evander Sandu is definitely in on the play for the Knights. So it was about a gain of a yard on that last play, bringing the ball back to the original line of scrimmage, 4th and 10 for Lord Tweedsmuir. Number 23, Keaton McPherson has him on the field to punt it away. And number 80, Nico Kanagawa is back deep for the Knights awaiting the stick. And a nice punt there by number 23, Keaton McPherson. End zone and for a cutback because this has been marked at the 20, and that is where the Knights will take over 1st and 10. It was great to see him handing the ball off to number 5, that's Gavin Shaw. Jackson Allen, number 10, in on the tackle for the Panthers. Number 33, Ryan Ryan, taking the handoff from Castillo. And number 56, that's Gabriel Perez, helping out on that tackle for the Panthers. The ball is across the 30, we'll call it the 31. That's good for the first down, first and 10 Knights. Taking the ball for the Knights. And number 73, Quentin Bryant making the tackle for the Panthers. Kanagawa taking the ball across the 40 to the 43. Gain of 12, good for the first down, first and 10 Knights. Ryan Lang, and he is met right at the line of scrimmage, 73 again. That's Quentin Bryant making the tackle for Lord Tweedsmuir. And the player shaken up for the Panthers, that's number 2, Nate Swing. Thomas Moore, Collegiate family, would love to thank the Bradford family for their support. With a little loss of a yard on that play, it'll be second and 11 now for St. Thomas Moore. A.J. Castillo handing the ball off to number 45, Leonardo Luna Rivera. And he was met immediately by number 10, that is Jackson Allen of the Panthers. Gain of a yard, back to the original line of scrimmage. Making a tackle there for the Panthers was number 12, Adam Long, and he had help from 6, Logan Wager. But not before Custodio takes it to the Panther 40-yard line, first and 10 Knights. Let's go! More area with the carry for St. Thomas More. Josh Van Cornet making the tackle for the Panthers. Gain of 7. And it'll be 2nd and 3 here for St. Thomas More. The ball is at the Panther 33-yard line. AJ Castillo hitting number 2, that is Dennis Flavis. Force out of bounds by number 9, that is William Petroia. Flavis taking the ball to the Panther 24-yard line. Good for the first down, 1st and 10 Knights. Number 19 again, Matthew Custodio taking a handoff from AJ Castillo for another big game. There are flags in the backfield, however. Number 3, Jack Roberts did make the tackle for the Panthers. We'll have to see what these flags are about. Holding is the call against St. Thomas More. That's going to move the ball back 10 yards. Actually, there were 2 holding calls on the same play. One has been declined, the other one's been accepted. Going to move the ball back to the 40-yard line of Lord Tweedsmuir. And the Knights will repeat 1st down from there. St. Thomas More. That will negate that last run by Nico Kanagawa. And the ball has now been moved back 10 yards to the 20. And St. Thomas More will be looking at a 1st and goal from there. St. Thomas More Collegiate would also like to thank Ms. Diane Doyle for her support to the program. Thank you very much. That is number 24, that is Tristan Cabini with the carry. Jackson Allen, number 10, making the tackle for the Panthers. He had a little help there from number 5, Eddie Amios. The game was 5. That'll bring up a second and goal from the Panther 15. Looking in the end zone for number 2, Dennis Lattis. Ball goes incomplete, there is a flag on the play. Defensive pass interference has been called against the Panthers. The ball will be placed at the 1 yard line. Actually, the ball has been placed at, looks like, the 7. Number 24, Tristan Cabini with the carry. Eddie Amios sending on the tackle for the Panthers. 36 Wilson Box helping out on that last play. So that last carry takes the ball to approximately the 3 or 4 yard line. And the Knights will be 3rd and goal from there.
Last time I was over there.
Yeah. Well, no one's texting yet, so a ton of people down there.
Yeah.
And they're watching.
Number 80, Nico Canavella taking it into the end zone for St. Thomas More from 4 yards out.
Or else we can hear it on the 6 yard line.
Well, the Panthers struck again. And
yep.
Now lead the Panthers 18-0 with the extra point yet to come.
I know, it's so loud. Because the boys, they were taking longer in there than I expected. I'm like, okay, we got to go in 1 minute. My coach was like, well, it's going to be more like 3.
Well, put the rollers on the field to attempt to pull after.
And then I turned it up a little bit more once they came out again. And yeah. Because
it worked out perfect. It's all good. They're like, well, we want to come out.
And he puts the two in the uprights.
So I'm like all stressed at
that. So the St. Thomas More Collegiate Knights now lead the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers 19-0. I believe it to be late here in the second quarter.
And the audience doesn't know what we're
doing. And while I have a moment, we would also like to thank on behalf of the St. Thomas More Collegiate community. ZLC, thank you very much for your support to the program.
Go Rex. You should jump on that while you're watching.
We're making an announcement that the player is now working at the PA booth to pay for merchandise. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the square is now working at the payment booth for the merchandise. It is now working. Thank you.
Oh, really?
It's on our fundraising list.
Oh, yeah.
Place.
Yeah, see, I'll just
The Logan Wager with the run back for the Panthers, taking it at his own 6-yard line, and he brings it out to the 20.
There is a horse.
He's brought down by number 8 of the Knights, that's Marcus Morales. 14-yard return there by Logan Wager. First and 10 Panthers from their 20. Joker having trouble coming up with the ball. It was dropped. We'll see who comes up with it. It looks like the Knights have recovered. So a big turnover here late in the second quarter. The Knights have recovered that fumble. I believe it was in number 10. That is AJ Castillo coming up with the ball. So with that turnover, the Knights will take over. First and 10 at the 25-yard line of the Panthers. That AJ Castillo pass is picked off in the end zone. That's their number 2, Nate Swing. There is a flag down, however. That interception will be negated by the pass interference penalty being called against the Panthers. So the Knights will repeat first down. Half the distance to the ball is marked down at, it looks like, the 13-yard line. And it'll be first and 10 from there for St. Thomas More. Timeout called on the field by St. Thomas More. Again, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to remind you that at halftime, St. Thomas More Collegiate will be having a very, very special presentation. We certainly hope that all of you will be here for that. Late here in the second quarter with the extra points at the ball. And Sal Piccolo is good again with the extra point. So St. Thomas More now leads 26-0 over the Lord Tweedsmuir Panthers.
Thank you.
How much nicer is it shooting that?
Good.
Yeah, we need to get that.
Yeah.
Get that Mr. Olsen, we need to get it. Right, like this.
So smooth and nice.
If we can get the players from 97, or sorry, 98 to 2007, the grade 8 football players from 1998 to 2007, come here to center field, please. I know there's lots of you here. Please come down to center field. Coach Rosado, Coach Hall are waiting. Coach Spanders as well. Calling all former grade 8 football players from 1998 to 2007. There's a few more. Come on down to center field. We're waiting for you. Guys from the beer garden, there's a few of you there. Come on out to center field.
While we're waiting for everyone to come to center field here for this presentation, I'd just like to say to Darrell Hall and Ron Casado, the coaches of the grade 8 football program, speaking on a personal level, just want to say you two gentlemen have been a very positive influence for my son who had the fortune of playing here. Thank you very much for all the efforts that you put into the program. From 1998 to 2007. They're talking with their old players. Daryl, Ron, I need you over here. Daryl never listens. He's never listens. Look at him. Ron, Daryl, come here, guys. It's okay. Ron, get over here, bud.
Pyrenees, the Pyrenees. Okay, it's all good. Okay, so we're very lucky to have a group of individuals here, managers included, and players. Come on, Dan Johnson, get over here. Football BC has honored our grade 8 football program from the years 1998 to 2007. They're honoring them and putting them into the Football BC Hall of Fame. These individuals will be honored next Saturday at the BC Lions game at halftime. And we felt, you know, it would be a perfect time to honor coaches, players. Coach Spanders here. We got Coach Crisado, Ron Crisado, Daryl Hall. Ron Crisado is in our STMC Hall of Fame. Daryl Hall has been here for decades, done so much as principal and other roles. We just want to honor you. The Parents Association has donated these wonderful stars for you guys. So enjoy. Thank you, STMCPA. Before I let Daryl speak, we have a little surprise for you. So if everybody could just take a look at that big screen over there and enjoy.
Okay, thank you. So I think French Chamber Carter said it best a couple of minutes ago. The countless championships, yes, and the amount of wins and all that, but I think more importantly, like Fred mentioned up there at the booth, the positive impact that you guys have had on these young men and young individuals at our school. So congratulations to you, Daryl. A few words, if you don't mind.
Ten. There was 10 consecutive provincial championships from 1998 to 2007. That's the program that's being honored by the BC Football Hall of Fame. And the interesting thing about that is that there's no other grade A football program that's ever been honored in this manner. So this is like a real coup, I think, for the school and its program to have those 10 consecutive championships. And just so you know, during those championships, there were 10. We had 91 wins and 3 losses in 10 years. So we had 7 years that were also undefeated, which is a pretty good record to have. I want to thank these are some of the guys, and there's going to be more of them out next week at the BC Lion game who will be honored at halftime. And there's a bit of a reception before the game for some of the players and coaches, etc. as well. So I want to thank these guys because they're the ones that make it possible when you have all these different coaches. And I want to mention, like, I can't mention all the different coaches we've had over the years. Between our alumni and our coaching staff. You look at our varsity coaching staff right now. Mr. Jared Power, he was on one of these teams that won the championship. He's the head coach of our varsity program right now. James Belgrade, he was on one of these championship teams. He's the offensive coordinator for the varsity program. And that's the continuity you want to see. And we see all these people come out like we have today. It just reminds me this is our second home. It's our home away from home. It's that key motto here, to be more. And with these guys, their hard work, determination, pursuit of excellence that they did all the way along, can't thank them enough. Because it's like, you know, it takes everybody to make a program like that and make it work. So I want to thank them, because I think they were the key. And I want to single out one individual. That's Mr. Wait. Ron Cruzado. I think he's the glue of it all from during that time. I can't think of anybody more to have coached with, better friend. And what people don't realize is he just didn't help out with football. He helped out with basketball. He refereed. Him and his wife did all kinds of dinner options for our school. They contributed so much to the school, so much service over the years. It's absolutely amazing. So the Cruzado family is a family I think that should be cherished at the school and highly recognized. And the school just wanted to do just a couple little tokens on behalf of Ron. So that's why I have this bag here. It's not because I'm a vagabond or something like that. So Ron, we got you your own graduation hoodie from the school. That's number one. We have your own jersey. That's for you. An up-to-date coaching staff jersey. Anyhow, thank you very much. We really appreciate your support. Thank you guys for all coming out.
Thank you. All right, let's play some football. Thank you, Daryl. Thanks, Ron. Let's go.
All right, thank you guys. This is an honor to be all of you.
You very well never be repeated. You're excellent coaches. You ran an excellent program here during those years. Thank you very much.
And we're about to get going here again.
Doing a great job, buddy. Thank you.
Tweedsmuir is going to take it. Late, so they're going to be coming shortly. For the kickoff, St. Thomas More leading 26-0 here.
There we go.
This homecoming game here in 2022.
I know, I don't know.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Bro, look at you.
That is bro O'Neill!
Yeah.
Oh, it's so nice to see you. Really good to see you. Where are you nowadays?
Okay, so I only missed
you. I didn't know that. Brent Cruzado.
Yep, yep.
Oh, well done.
Get your name on it.
Oh, that's right. He went to see Tara the cat. You remember that?
Nobody forgets
that.
Not a lot of people know that
story. She got that. Oh, sure.
Oh, Ed
was 22.
Right. Oh,
in the cabin.
Oh, you got your own hoodie. With, hey, oh, with your years of service.
Nice to see you. I'm glad you're here.
For the school.
Well,
Number 6, Noel Faria, taking the handoff there from Seguro. Unique swing, and number 73, Quinton Bryant, were there on the tackle for the Panthers. A gain of 5 on that last play by St. Thomas More, and it'll be 2nd and 5.
Okay, guys, just see the down box, you can drop.
First down. Michael can go on the 80, number 4, Jack Sutherland. We're in on the back of the night. But up before King Clay ran by the Panthers, Chelsea going to the field. Play here.
goes against the Knights. Personal foul is going to fall against St. Thomas More.
Go!
And then Joe Hall taking up for the Knights, being brought down by number 5. That is Eddie Amios. Joe Hall with a carry of 9 yards. Second and 1 Knights. The ball's at the 39. And then go home again, Jerry Ball, and brought down immediately by number 22, Gain of a couple on the play, good enough for the first down. The ball is at 41, first and 10 Knights.
Thank you.
to the beer garden and to all of our vendors that have good food. And we're ready to go again here for Kingsland Knights.
First to 10. Boys! Jay! Let's go up, Jay!
Hey, you're a flat money. Boys!
Run!
Why haven't they?
Congratulations to the Knights, and good luck to the Panthers as they continue this. everybody who helped out to make this a memorable afternoon. Thank you for the volunteers, staff, faculty. Thank you very much. And by all means, we hope that you hang around for a little while and enjoy the gardens and enjoy all the good food that we have down at the south end of the field. Thank you. Thank you very much, everybody. Just bear with us. Thank you.